colleagues 15 years ago at a similar conference in Lisbon, I made a preliminary report about the Ural megaliths. But now, after the publication of the monograph, we can discuss the main problems of these studies. Well, megaliths are first of all a European phenomenon, but in recent years megalithic complexes have been found in the Urals. This led us to the old problems of megalithic studies. Was this tradition everywhere of local origins, or was it a result of migration or cultural influences? It's connected with conditions for the formation of megalithic tradition, because the building was possible in a case of large collectives and the presence of rich resources. However, in the Ural Eneolithic, agriculture was absent. This means there were no local grounds for the megalithic tradition. On the other hand, the Ural Mountains are separated from the nearest megalithic areas by a very long distance. The first megalithic objects were discovered in the steppe zone of the Trans-Urals. These are relatively small menhirs, a stone row and a stone cycle at a hunglo. Excavators suggested its astronomical orientation, but there was one feature, a circle of small holes was found around the central menhir. It's very similar to the Aubrey holes found at Stonehenge. Earthen structures, Bakshai and Savin, became a new type of Eneolithic monuments. Researchers suggested their similarity to Central European rondels or British henges. Later, many dolmens were found in the forest of the Middle Urals. But all these objects are relatively small and simple. And if I want to say, yes, this area is part of the megalithic tradition, we must have really megalithic object there. Such objects were discovered on the Vera Island of Lake Turgoyak. The unique character of this complex is that it has many megalithic objects of different types. The island is small, but archaeological sites occupy 43% of its territory. It's a granite ridge dividing the island into warm southern and colder northern parts. It can be seen from the fact that they have different vegetation. Therefore, all settlements are in the south. In the north, there are only some unclear objects. Most of the megaliths are located along the ridge. In the center, there is a high rock with sanctuary and a sculpture of an animal head. In the east of the island, there is a sanctuary with phallomorphic menhirs, an altar and several fireplaces. Lines between the menhirs are directed to the sunrise at the equinox and the solstices. Most finds were situated in the area of the altar stone, but one ceramic type was situated near the central menhir and the second near a small menhir in the west. In general, the complex reflects the idea of birth and human cycles included in the cycles of nature. Analysis of details of this complex allowed us to conclude that in this place marriages were concluded between groups with different origins. The chamber at megaliths of the island reflect other ideas. One of them was probably used only for burials. It has two chambers. Above the entrance to the south chamber is a light box, identical to the light box in New Grange and in some other Irish and British passage graves. At the equinox, the rays of the setting sun illuminate the shelf inside. The northern chamber is made of large boulders, but the north wall is made of a vertically placed slab. Pay attention to this detail. The upper corner of the slab are broken away. We initially thought it was a random detail, but it's repeated in another megalith of the island, also made of boulders, and this has analogies in the Irish wedge tombs. The floor in the chamber was covered with clay, and the slabs of the ceiling were laid in such a way that a sort of arc formed in the center. There is a niche above the shelf at the eastern wall of the structure. The largest megalith is built along the ridge. It has three chambers. In the east, a long corridor leads to the megalith from above. Through this corridor, one could get into the large central hall, and from there to the western and northern chambers having small pits on the floor. The megalith is covered with massive slabs. The largest are in the central hall. Interior of this hall is the most complex. It has windows, a partition, niches, and stone sculptures of heads of bull and wolf inserted in the walls. The megalith contains ceramics and flint blades of the Eneolithic period. But the island is interesting not only for this large megalith. There is a quarry where large slabs were extracted using wooden levers to cover the megaliths, as well as large stone blocks which were split into smaller blocks with wooden wedges. Finally, there are settlements of this time and several dwellings with stone foundations and some unclear structure with a menhir and a stone paving. The collection from the settlements is very rich. Excavations show that there were no traces of agriculture. Very little traces of various industries, ceramics, flint tools, remains of metallurgy. These settlements combine different ceramic types, indicating different origins of people. Some types of vessel, for example decorated in slab and drag technique, have analogies in northwestern Europe, but many others have local Neolithic roots. We have made a detailed statistical analysis of all the finds. As a result, we see a gradual transition from making tools on flint blades to making tools on flakes. The shape of the blades becomes simpler and the blades larger. It's correlated with bone remains, which demonstrate a gradual shift from predominantly fishing and bird hunting to hunting larger and larger animals. But in any case, during all this time, hunting and fishing were the basis of the life, and therefore the economic basis of the megalithic phenomenon in the Urals. Well, how may we interpret this situation in terms of the general megalithic problem? In the Urals, this phenomenon had no local roots. We don't see a gradual development of the megalithic tradition. Finally, there were no conditions for this, because there was no agriculture. Therefore, this could only arise as a result of migration. Some features in megaliths and ceramics suggest that northwestern Europe could be this original area. But these are not always strict parallels. Some features could arise independently, as they reflect universal human ideas. Even some identical features in megaliths could be caused by logic of building from large stones. Therefore, we can divide the similar features in our and European megaliths into background and specific ones. The background ones are menhirs, stone rings, dolmens, since the simple construction of four slabs is similar everywhere. Astronomical orientations, clay plaster, stones, wet stones in the ceiling, and so on. There are some specific details, like light boxes above the entrance and a long corridor from the east. They have parallels in the passage graves, but in general the structure is different. This was probably caused by the need to adapt the structure to its location on the ridge and to provide penetration of light into the megalith from the desired directions. There are ceramics with ornaments made in the stab and drag technique with parallels in Germany. But this is not enough. However, all these analogies together may be considered as a complex similarity. Therefore, in general, we believe that this is an alien complex, but the question of its roots remains open. We see interaction with local people. This can be seen in the presence of different types of pottery in the settlements and especially on the menhirs sites. Obviously, in order to create this complex and for its functioning, it was necessary to control a large territory inhabited by local people. And probably the megaliths played a role in consolidating this collective of newcomers, in demonstrating the dominance of their religion and ideology. However, there was no economic basis for this, and gradually the megalithic tradition disappeared. Of course, this is only the most general outline of the problems to be solved. And I think that the Ural megaliths will present us many surprises in the future.